kay Jan. Okay, let's proceed again. Magandang hapon ulit sa inyo, mga kasama. Or the police organization. Badge, gentlemen and ladies. We will be discussing, in an organization, merong kanya-kanyang mga logo. Ang NBI, may sarili sila. Ang immigration, ang customs. So, sa Philippine National Police, we are being represented by the signal, the symbol of our authority, which is the PNP badge. Okay. The badge is being symbolized by different logos. Andun yung Philippine monkey eating eagle. What does it represent? The bird is a symbol of swiftness, mabilis, kumilos. Power, courage, katapangan, and immortality. Indeed, namamatay ang police. Pero ang ibig sabihin yan, ang police organization, hindi nawawala. Panahon pa ni Kristo, meron ng police organization. Am I right? Hinuli nga si Kristo di ba? Ng mga Hudyo nung araw. Yun ang mga law enforcement officers nung araw. And until now, the police organization exists. The shield, what does the shield symbolizes? It is the symbol of protection. Kaya nga meron kaming ganyan We have to protect your lives and properties. Now, the eight sun rays, it represents, of course, the Philippine flag represents the sun rays, the eight provinces na lumaban sa mga mananako. The three stars represents the Luzon, the Visayas, and the Mindanao. Bravery, yung silapu-lapu, mga kasama. Diba? He is a symbol of bravery of the Filipino people. Laurel leaves, yung mga dahon-dahon, competency, brilliance, talino, at honor. May honor ang members ng PNP dapat. Likewise, according to the Police Act of 1966, September 8, 1966, this serves as the legal guidepost in initiating a national level the much-needed reforms, resulting to a considerable improvement in the police service. Kinreate ang NAPOLCOM under the office of the President. Kasi nung araw, wala pang NAPOLCOM. And according to Presidential Decree No. 765, ang PCINP ang binuo and the nucleus of the PCINP is the Philippine Constabulary. By then, panahon namin, pupunta kami sa krami. Puro PC mga sigaron. Kung pagalitan kami ng mga PC, kasi sila ang mga ang bumubuo ang cream ng Philippine National Police, ng Philippine Constabulary Integrated National Police. I was a member of the Integrated National Police. Diyan ako recruit. Okay. Then, sa 1987 Constitution, it provides that the state shall establish and maintain one police force. Hindi na, inalis na ang PCINP, isa na lang. Kaya ginawang Philippine National Police under the administration and control of the National Police Commission. Okay. Then, in 1991, July 23, ang Republic Act 1969-75 was enacted, which established the PNP under the reorganized DILG and for other purposes. Under the PNP, mga kasama, the philosophy is service, honor, and justice. Nakikita niyo yan sa badge ng PNP, logo ng PNP, service, honor, and justice. Okay. 855 bang ngayon, ipinasa. In 1998, the Act providing for the reform and reorganization of the PNP. Oh. The core values of the Philippine National Police is makajos, makatao, makabansa, at makakalikasan. Self-explanatory. Okay. The mission. The PNP shall enforce the law, prevent and control crime, maintain peace and order and ensure public safety and internal security with the active support of the community. The PNP cannot survive without the support of the community. Now, ongoing yata ngayon sa Luneta, yung suporta ng komunidad ng Manila, magbibigay ng 100 na bagong mobile patrol, suporta sa komunidad ng Maynila sa Philippine National Police, particularly Manila Police District. Okay. Ano, power one, dadaming yan ang nagpapatrol. Pag dumami nagpapatrol, hindi mabibigyan ng pagkakataon for the criminals to commit crime because there will be no more opportunity for them to commit crimes. Okay, the National Police Commission is headed by the SILG, di ba? Secretary of the Interior and Local Government. The NAPOLCOM has its chairman. The chairman is the SILG. Okay. Composition of the NAPOLCOM, it has four composed of chairperson, si General Anyo, siya ang DILG ngayon, and four regular commissioner. Sa mga commissioner, isa dyan, ex-officio chairman si Chief PNP. Kahit sinong Chief PNP, laging ex-officio chairman member ng commission. Three of the regular commissioners shall come from the civilian sector. Okay, civilian ha. Oh, yung mga retired na PNP, minsan ginagawang commissioner dyan. And who are neither active, retired na yun, kailangan. Non-active or civilian. One of whom shall be designated as the vice chairperson. Okay, may isang, yung chairman sa DILG, tapos may vice chairman siya. Kasi masyadong busy, syempre, delegated ang authority kay vice chair. And of course, the fourth regular commissioner shall come from the law enforcement sector, either active or retired. Okay, kaya nga nandyan, ex-officio chairman si Chief PNP, ex-officio member. An active member shall be a considered resign once appointed. Halimbawa, ikaw, in-appoint ka na regular commissioner, teka muna, i-resign ka. Pero si Chief PNP, hindi, kasi matik yun, laging dapat ang Chief PNP is always an ex-officio member. Okay. At least one of the commissioners shall be a woman. What is the rationale behind? Simply because they want to be that the women sector should be represented. That there should be a woman member of the commission. Term of office, four regular and full-time commissioners shall be appointed by the president for a term of 6 years without reappointment or extension. Pag natapos mo na yung six years mo, papalitan ka na. Okay. Let's continue. Disregard this break. Organizational setup of the PNP. Saan makikita ang national headquarters? Of course, of the national headquarters in Camcramic, Quezon City. Okay, remember this. Ano? Tinanong ito sa board. What does it mean when you say command group? When you say command group, yun yung tatlong siga sa Crame. The Chief PNP, the Deputy Chief for Admin, the Deputy Chief for Operation, and the Chief Directorial Staff. Apat. Yung mga ibang staff, yung Directorate for Investigation, they are not a member of the command group. Ha? Bapag tinanong, what the following are members of the command group except? Okay. Basta tandaan nyo, ito lang apat. Sa region naman, sino ang who consists the regional command group? The RD, the DRDA, Deputy Regional Director for Administration, the Deputy Regional Director for Operation, DRDO, and the RCDS, Regional Chief Directorial Staff. Replicated, kung ano yung position ng mga nando sa Crame, may position sa mga regional offices, sa district offices. Okay? Let's proceed. Again, minimum qualification in joining the PNP. I have discussed this. Si Filipino citizen, good moral character, neuropsychiatric, drug test, baccalaureate degree. Okay. Eligible, no dishonorable dismissal from government position or military and the police service, no final judgment. Okay. Height, di ba? Mga kasama, kita niya yan. Si Dagul at saka si Mahal. Ito, ginanda nito kay Dagul. Gustong magpulis nito pero hindi na. Kasi ang galing ng talent nito, kung alam niyo lang. Ang galing nito sa photography, gentlemen. Kaya lang, nalugi. Hindi nag-click. Why? Kasi pagkuha niya ng litrato, laging hanggang tuhod lang eh. Hanggang bewang lang. Ito naman si Mahal, sana magpupulis woman ito. Kaya lang, nung pinagpunta sa CR, imbis na maghilamos dun sa lababo, dun sa inidoro lang, naghihilamos. Akala niya, ang ihian yung stream. Hanggang dun lang siya natatapat. Okay, let's proceed. Timbang, not more or less, not less than or more than 5 kilograms sa kanyang height. Okay. Sinabi ko sa inyo kahapon, yung edad, not be less than 21 nor more than 30 years of age. Again ha, 30 years, 11 months na siya, pasok pa siya, hindi pa siya 31. Okay. Waivers, ito yung mga waivers na binibigay. Age waiver, lumagpas ka ng edad o mas bata ka sa edad. Mas bata ka sa edad, maghintay ka lang ng isang taon o dalawang taon. Apply ka na. Pero yung overage, 35 lang ha, pag pwedeng 31, pero pagka binigyan ano, pagka hanggang 35 pwede kang mag-waiver, pag 36 na talagang hindi na. Height, panda, cultural minorities. Weight, to comply within 6 months. Pag bumagsak ka sa weight ngayon, by the next cycle of recruitment, pwede ka uling mag-apply. Okay. Education. Hindi na ngayon pinagbibigyan ng waiver for education, educational waiver, simply because dapat tapusin na ngayon. That is already a law. Nung araw, even if it is mandatory for you to be a graduate of a four-year course, may mga undergrad na tinanggap dahil kulang ang aplikante sa SAF. Yun. Pero ngayon, hindi na mandatory na, kaya hindi na nagbibigay ang NAPOL. Who issues waivers? Yan ang tanong. It is the NAPOLCOM that issues waiver. Ha? Okay. Under the waiver, kung may mga waiver cut kayo, it can only be applied if applicants are lacking to meet the quota. Kulang ang aplikante. And appointment under waiver program shall be temporary and last priority. Kaya dapat talaga, hanggat maaari, walang waiver. Pag talagang sobra-sobra ang quota sa aplikante, tinatanggap. Selection, ang criteria under the waiver program. Ang essence nito, ang chronology of accepting waiver, unang-una yung tawag dito yung height muna, tapos yung age, tapos yung weight, kasi yung weight hindi naman inaano yan eh, tsaka education, hindi naman na masyadong problema yung weight, madaling magpagaang, madaling magpataba, pero education talaga. Ngayon, least disqualification, pare-pareho kayo may waiver. Yung isa ang waiver niya, height tsaka age. Yung isa ang waiver niya, height lang. Siyempre, mas priority munang tatanggapin yung may height waiver. Oh, let's proceed. All uniform members of the PLP shall undergo field training program. This is, I've told you na yung OJT. This is 6 months na lang ngayon, dati 12 months, di ba? Kasi yung field training program, in-house 6 months, then in-house 6 months. Then OJT or FTP 6 months. Okay. The appointing authorities, of course, I've discussed this to you yesterday. Patrolman to PEMS, Master Sergeant, by the Regional Director ang pumipirma ng appointment if sa region sila naka-assign. Basta remember, from Lieutenant to Light Colonel, the appointing authority is the Chief PNP. Full-fledged Colonel to General, it is always the President. Okay? And the attesting government agency is the Civil Service Commission. Tinanong din sa board yan, what is the central government agency that issues attested appointment to go all government employees? It is the Civil Service Commission. Lateral entry, I've discussed this to you, gentlemen. PNPA, okay. And qualification for provincial directors, baka lang ilabats na inyo sa board exam. Holder of master's degree, pag provincial director, ang position na pa-applyan mo. Master's in Public Administration, Master's in Science and Criminology, and of course, graduated these courses from a reputable institution. Recognized institution. Has satisfactorily passed the required training. As I told you yesterday, For every rank for promotion, you have to undergo different mandatory schooling. And the first ever training that you have to undergo is Public Safety Basic Recruit Course. Qualification of Chief of Police. City or Police Office. Graduate of Bachelor of Laws, Master's Degree, and of course, mandatory schooling. Sa Municipal Police Station, at least second year Bachelor of Laws. At least 12 units sa Master's Degree. Okay? Provided that a member of the bar with at least 5 years of law practice, less po ka, 5 years ka ng abogado, or licensed criminologist ka, or graduate of the PNPA ka, you may be appointed as the chief of police or of the city or municipality. Attrition system. This is what I've told you yesterday. Attrition system is the concept of the PNP that means the loss of the personnel of its organization in the normal course of events. Ano yan? Halimbawa, maximum tenure na na-reach mo na yung 10 years mo, ay yung 2 years mo. I-attrite ka na, lipat ka na, relieve ka na. Unless there is an exemption, there is an extension. Always, there is a rule, there is an exception. Like the position of the chief PNP. Upon the prerogative of the president, he extended the retirement of General Bato, General De La Rosa. Retired na siya ng 56 siya. At the age of 57 siya pinag-retire ni presidente. And that is the prerogative of the appointing authority. Okay? Relief. Nirelieve ka. That is also called. That's attrition. Relieve ka. Non-promotion for 10 years. Gentlemen and ladies, hindi ka na po promote for 10 years. Permanent ang appointment mo. Permanent ka sa rango mo. You will be attrited. Tatanggalin ka sa serbisyo. Pero pag more than 20 years of age, 20 years in the service ka na, hindi ka basta tatanggalin. Tatanggalin ka, pero i-consider kang retired. That is forced retirement. Okay? Let's proceed. The maximum tenure of PNP members holding their position, puro 2 years. Tandaan nyo yan, ha? Chief PNP, Deputy Chief PNP, puro 2 years lang yan. Yung iba nga hindi nakakatapos dahil inaabot ng retirement. Nalilipat. So, 2 years ang maximum. Upon reaching the maximum tenure without being promoted or assigned to a higher level, bawa nakaposisyon ka, 2 years ka na, inirelieve ka ngayon, hindi ka ngayon ipinwesto. 20 years ka na, ilang buwan ka nang hindi nakapwesto, 6 months kang walang pwesto, ayaw mo nang kumuha ng pwesto, i-attrite ka na, po-force retirement ka na. Pagka more than 20 years in the service ka na. That is the so-called attrition. Attrition by relief, 2 years pala yun. Hindi ka na po pwesto, na-relieve ka, tas 2 years, i-attrite ka. Pag wala ka pang 20 years, separated. Meron ka namang terminal fee na ibibigay sa'yo. Okay. Any personnel, uniform personnel or non-uniform personnel who is relieved and reassigned to a position lower than what is established for his grade. Halimbawa, coronel ka. Na-relieve ka ngayon doon sa pwesto mo. Nilagay ka sa pwesto ng major. Ha? More than 18 months ka nang nasa posisyon ng major, i-attrite ka na. Kasi, wala yung posisyon mo, yung rango mo, wala doon sa tamang posisyon. Hindi mo na gustong bumalik. Nasa iyo yun eh, ba't ayaw mo lumipat sa posisyon na that suits your rank? Eh, ayaw mo, tamad ka. It's better for you to be retired, forcibly or attrited. Okay? Any personnel who has not been promoted for a continuous period of 10 years shall be retired or separated. Yan, nasa attrition system, in the PNP, pag 10 years kang walang posisyon, hindi na po promote, you will be considered as attrited, forcibly retired, or you will be separated from the service. Attrition by other means. Personnel with at least 5 years of accumulated active service shall be separated based on the following factors. Poor performance. Dalawang dikit ka na poor ang iyong evaluation, appraisal. I-attrite ka. Tapos, sunod-sunod na cumulative na taon. Three consecutive or cumulative. Halimbawa, dalawa ngayon. Sa susunod, naging satisfactory ka. Sumunod na naman. Poor ka na naman. Attrition ka. physical or mental incapacity, karoon ka ng problema sa isip, at saka pangangatawan. Eh, pagka ganun i-attract ka, you better apply. Halimbawa, nagkasakit ka. Your physical inability makes you unable to work. So, mag-apply ka na lang ng disability para magpe-pension ka. Kesa naman, i-attract ka lang. Okay. Failure to pass the required entrance exam. What does it mean? For any every schooling, halimbawa, you will be undergoing mandatory course for promotion. Titira ka ng junior leadership course. For every mandatory schooling that you'll be taking for you to be promoted, bago ka makapasok, we have the so-called qualifying exam. Pag hindi ka nakakapasa sa qualifying exam, mahinang klase ka, dalawang beses na, so therefore hindi ka makapag-schooling. Paano kang mapopromote kung wala kang mandatory schooling? So, i-attract ka na lang. You're a police officer. Use your initiative to pass the exam. Sa college niya eh. You're able to pass the course. Kahit na mahina ang pagkakaintindi mo, di ba? Ibig sabihin, you have the ability, meron kang diskarte. Tapos, less mo ka na. Qualifying exam lang, hindi mo mapasa. Napakahina mo naman, dumiskarte, mama. Okay. Let's go now to the promotion. Promotion by virtue of position. This happened to me, as I've discussed to you yesterday. I was then a major. I was designated to a position for police superintendent. Thus, I was promoted to police superintendent because there is a vacancy for promotion. Okay. Regular promotion. Ito yung sinasabi ko sa inyo. You have reached the time and grade. About 3 years from patrolman to corporal. Meron ka na nun. Meron ka ng schooling, meron ka ng eligibility, meron ka ng PO exam from the NAPOLCOM, or you have passed the civil service exam, you are already a board passer, you will apply for promotion. Once promoted, that is what we call the regular promotion. Special promotion is what we call, of course, the SPAT promotion. Okay? Exhibited acts. Posthumous! O yan, baka gusto niyan. Ang ganda niyan, di ba? Napatay ka sa laban, may bandera pa yung kabaong mo, may nakatayo pang mga pulis na naka-take as pahinga. Diba? Ang ganda tignan! Joke lang ha? Tapos sasaluduhan ka pa ni Chief PNP or ni RD pagdating doon. Dalpot. Ililibing ka ngayon. Meron ka pa 21 gun salute. Tut-tut-tut! Tut-tut-tut! O, diba? Di na, kanila na lang yun. Di bali nang wag ma-promote ng post ng one rank higher. Kaya ko sa regular yan. Wag lang yung... Remember, gentlemen and ladies, ha? It's better for every police officer to face the judge. Remember that. You are found guilty for shooting to death so-and-so, and you are hereby met the penalty of reclusion perpetua. Di ba? Meron tayong amnesty, meron tayong anong tinatawag sa Malacanang, the so-called presidential pardon. Lalayat lalaya ka. Judge ang nag-convict sa iyo. Pa. Yung kanyang antag doon. Attorney yung ano may tawag yung pamukpok ng judge. Pa, 'di ba? Session adjourned. Chok. Eh kesa naman ang kaharap mo. 'Di ba? Ang hahatol sa iyo. Yung Paris priest na simbahan. Ominus Dominum Spiritum. Amen. 6 feet below the ground, gentlemen and ladies. Just joking, pero totoo to. Okay. Let's proceed. Salaries and benefits for retirees, as I've discussed to you yesterday, 36 years lump sum advance yung pension mo, yung league credits mo na nakuha, and the early retirement or the optional retirement is 20 years in the service, and mandatory age of retirement is 56. There is a bill pending before the Congress, ha? Tawag dito, ang retirement benefit, retirement year daw tao is compulsory, is 65 years old, napakabigat nun. Tapos optional retirement is 30 years in the service. Parang napakabigat, mga kasama. Okay, let's proceed. Then we had the lump sum, okay. Permanent physical disability, that's as what I've lectured you yesterday. Yung tinatawag natin na nagkasakit ka, you are incapable anymore of rendering duty. You'll be declared as retired due to permanent physical disability. Ang advantage nga nito, dalawa ang pension mo. You'll be receiving pension from the PNP and from the NAPOLCOM. Okay? Kaya nga lang, hindi bali na, mas maganda mag-retire na kumpleto ang katawan. Okay. Members of the PNP shall be considered as employees of the national government. Yun nga, dati local government ang nag-a-appoint, ang nagpapasweldo. Now it is the national government. The IAS. Under Republic Act 8551, the IAS has investigative and adjudicatory powers over PNP. As I told you yesterday, the IAS is not a disciplinary authority. Di siya makakapag-suspend, di siya makakapag-dismiss. They already have the recommendatory power. Okay? And the approving authority is the disciplinary authority. Kaya lang, sa investigation matters, kabahan ka dyan. Kasi sometimes, always pala, if they do recommend that you, they found you guilty and they recommend that the following will be the vetted penalty, kinakagat ni Chief PNP yan, kinakagat ni RT yan. Eh kung nag-recommend dyan ng dismissal, you will be dismissed from the service. It is also the it also acts as the ombudsman of the PNP. Ang talim ng IAS pag kung ano ang investigation nila at kung ano ang findings nila as if approved in principle by the disciplinary authority. Okay. The IAS shall be headed by an inspector general. Ang tawag doon IG. Dapat civilian, ha? Ngayon civilian na. Dati laging police. Kaya lang, according to the congressman, bakit ngayon ina-apply yan? Bakit yan puro mga active pa yan? Diba? So magkakaroon ng clout ang PNP over the IAS director. Kaya niyang diktahan. Kasi ang budget ng IAS comes from the PNP. So hindi pwedeng maging independent tapos ang nakaupo is police. That is in blatant violation of the law. So according to 8551, it should be a civilian. Kaya ngayon, civilian na nandyan. Si Attorney Triambulo. Okay. The IG shall be appointed by the President upon the recommendation of the Chief PNP and endorsed by the NAPOLCOM. Okay. Powers and function of the IAS: conduct inspection, audit, investigate complaints, conduct summary hearing, submit report to the Chief PNP, file appropriate cases against PNP members. Bawa, if a police officer was complained of in the IAS, ang IAS will be filing a criminal case against you and the administrative case will be handled by the IAS. Okay? Sa court nila ipapile. Ayan, tanong. Paano, sir, pag taga-IAS ang nakakommit ng crime? Saan namin irereklamo yan? Of course. They have to be filed to the IAS also. Sa Inspector General. Okay? He is not immune from suit. Como taga-IAS siya, he is still a member of the organization. Okay. Disciplinary mechanism. Pagka na-complain ka sa Chief of Police, as I've discussed earlier, the Chief of Police can give you suspension for 15 days. He can give you lower penalties such as reprimand, withholding of privileges, and forfeiture of salary. 15 days lang lagi. And mayors, 15 days, 16 days to 30 days. Pag kay mayor nagreklamo yan, si mayor pinaimbestigan ka, 16 to 30 days. Pleb, suspension, forfeiture of salary, 30 days. Pero pwede kanyang bigyan ng dismissal and demotion. Yan ha, ang bigat ng pleb. And of course, Chief of Police, ito yung kanyang mga kayang ibigay, provincial director, not exceeding 30 days, regional director, pag suspension, 60 days ang maximum. Pero mas mababa pa rin kaya niya ibigay. Forfeiture of salary, reprimand, pero pwede siya sa dismissal and demotion. Kay Chief PNP, ang pinakamataas na suspension niya is 6 months, 180 days, and dismissal and demotion. Okay. Bakit ito? Si Regional Director and the Chief PNP has the right, has the authority to give dismissal and demotion. Under the principle again of the power to hire and to fire. Huh? He can hire you, so therefore he can fire you. He can promote you, so therefore he can demote you. Yun ang, ano nun, yun ang esensya. Summary dismissal authority. The NAPOLCOM, the CPNP, and the RD. Ito lang ha, yung mga mabibigat na kaso, grave cases. They can do the summary dismissal proceedings, of course, always in compliance to the mandate of due process. Alam niyo naman yung due process, the right to be heard and before being condemned. Okay? Notice and hearing. The two elements of due process is notice and hearing. Kaya-kaya ni attorney yan, siya na bahala dyan. What is forum shopping? Hindi pwedeng hindi lalabas sa board exam. Okay? Forum shopping is filing of a complaint, either criminal or administrative, involving the same cause of action. Nagpunta ka sa criminal court, umakyat sa RTC ng Manila, nag-file ka rin ng criminal case, umakyat sa RTC ng Pasig, parehong-pareho. That, madi-dismiss yung pangalawang pinag-filean mo. The first court which acquired jurisdiction over the complaint or over the case will proceed. And the second one will be dismissed under the principle of forum shopping. Ganon din sa admin case. Nagpunta ka sa IAS. You file the complaint against the police officer at the IAS. It rolled on. Nandun na, tuloy-tuloy na. However, yung tao hindi pa satisfied for him to get a favorable decision. Pumunta man, may kakampi siya sa ombudsman, nag-file uli sa ombudsman, or nag-file sa NAPOLCOM. Okay. I, as the respondent, will be filing a motion for dismissal of the case sa ombudsman or the NAPOLCOM under the principle of forum shopping. Madi-dismiss yun. The first quasi-judicial body that acquires jurisdiction over my case is the IAS. Doon siya sa IAS eh. Yun ang magtutuloy. Yun sa IAS. Why? Biruin mo na may merwisyo na lang yun. Abogado ka doon sa IAS, abogado ka sa ombudsman, abogado ka ron, hearing ka. Eh, walang mangyayari, di ba? Iisang cause of action lang naman ang pinag-uusapan. Na may merwisyo lang. So, isa lang ang will be proceeding. Okay. Composition of the plebe, mga kasama. Any member of the sangguniang panlusod, bayan, chosen by respective sangguniang. Any barangay captain chosen by the Association of Barangay Captain. Three other members chosen by the Concerned Peace and Order Council among the respected members of the community. One of whom must be a member of the bar. My classmate, Sir J. Peraro, may be a member of the plebe. Oh, di ba? Or in the absence thereof, a college graduate or principal of the elementary school. Kadalasan, magbobotohan ang members ng plebe. Who will be the chairman of the plebe? Kadalasan, nagiging chairman is the lawyer. Okay? Kaya, sir mate, nag-plebe ka na. Note, the chairman shall be elected from among themselves. Sila ngayon ang mag-e-elect. And one member of the plebe must, pag sinabing must, mandatory, hindi directory, obligado, dapat merong isang babae to represent the women sector. Okay. Appeal. Okay. Halimbawa, you are found guilty in an administrative case by the regional office, regional director. Sabi ng regional director, you are hereby found guilty and you are met the penalty of demotion, one rank demotion. Okay. One rank demotion. Magpapail ka ngayon kay RD ng motion for reconsideration. And when the resolution came out resolving your motion for reconsideration, you will be, your motion is denied. Motion denied. Okay. The same. The motion will stand. Paano ka na? Mandidemote ka na ba? No. Within the period prescribed by law, by 855, by Memorandum Circular 2016-002 of the NAPOLCOM, you have to file your appeal. Okay? Kanino ka magpapail ng appeal? Sa NAPOLCOM, which is the higher office. Pag regional director ang nagbigay ng penalty, saan sa NAPOLCOM? Sa Regional Appellate Board. RAB. Ha? Pero pag sakrami ka naman, dinesisyon ng kanit si PNP ng guilty, demotion or dismissal, nag-motion for reconsideration ka, denied The rule is that you will be filing your appeal to the NAPOLCOM, but not to the RAB, to the NAB, National Appellate Board. Kasi si Chief PNP, NAB, national ang kanyang jurisdiction. Si RD, regional ang kanyang jurisdiction. Question is, hindi ka pulis ng region, pulis krami ka. Okay? Ang nag-dismiss sa'yo, ang nag-demote sa'yo, yung iyong director, ba si IDG ka, si director si IDG ang nagbigay ng penalty ng devotion. Saan ka magpapail ngayon ng appeal? Hindi si Chief PNP yun, hindi si regional director yun. The rule is that you will be filing your appeal with the NAPOLCOM Regional Appellate Board. RAB pa rin. Okay? Kasi, yung mga director ng NSU, katumbas yan ng director ng region. Sa pagdating sa disciplinary authority. Okay? Let's proceed. Oh, period of appeal, 10 days lang. When we say 10 days, under legal, ang tawag doon? Statutory construction na napag-aralan ko, and I believe my classmate, lawyer, attorney Peraro, will agree with me, that in counting the days, you should exclude the first day and include the last day. Halimbawa, you have received, from the date of receipt, na-receive mo ngayon yun. Hindi ngayon magsisimula, bukas pa ang bilang ng count. Okay? Nang 1 to 10 days. Tanong sa board, yung period of appeal, 10 days, is it calendar days or working days? Sabi ng rules, it is always calendar days. Kasama ang Sabado at Linggo at holiday. Okay? Then, nag-file ka ng appeal sa RAB NAPOLCOM or sa NAB NAPOLCOM, the rule is that the appellate board shall resolve your appeal within 60 days. Okay? 60 days. Creation of women desk in the police offices, lahat ng istasyon, lahat ng unit should always have their own women's desk or the so-called WCPS istasyon, Women and Child Protection Section. Kaya nga meron tayong women's division sa Camp Krame, being headed by General Makabinta. Local executives, mga mayor, mga kasama, ano papel nila sa PNP? Mayors and governors are, once elected, are automatically deputized by the NAPOLCOM. Deputy yan. Deputized pala yan. They have the power to employ and deploy and to recommend to the PD the transfer, reassignment, and detail of PNP members. That's why, pagka, di ba, there are times that if you are applying in the regional office, you have to secure recommendation from the local mayor. Okay. Ngayon, nabakante ang Office of Provincial Director, na-relieve si PD. The PNP or the regional office will recommend to the governor 3 recommendees, 3 full-fledged colonel. Ito po ang rekomendasyon namin, Gov. Pumili po kayo dito sa 3. Okay? Pag sa mayor naman, sa city, nabakante ang chief of police, magre-recommenda ang this ang regional office kay mayor ng 5 naman na pagpipilian. The question is, sa mga narekomendang 3 kay governor, sa 5 narekomenda kay mayor, wala siyang nakursunadahan. Hindi siya pumili. Okay. What? Ano? Vacuum? Vacant? No. The PNP will place an OIC. Hindi po pwedeng mabakante. Magkakaroon ng OIC. Okay? For 30 days, OIC. Tapos, that 30 days, meron ulit panibagong rekomendasyon kay Mayor. Pipili na si Mayor yan. Siyempre, laging pinipili ni Mayor yung bata niya. Okay. The local government unit shall have the power to direct, superintend, and to oversee the day-to-day function of police investigation of crime, crime prevention. Mga kasama, when I was the OIC or the Deputy Chief of Police of Mandaluyong, nag-hepering nga ako dyan, may lagi ako kay Mayor. Kasi pag nag-utos si Mayor, susundin mo. They have the right, the authority to superintend and oversee the day-to-day function of the police. And in return, bibigay ng allowance si Mayor for every member of the police service. Kasama yan sa batas. Okay? Suspension or withdrawal of deputation. They are automatically deputized by the NAPOLCOM to oversee the PNP operational and administrative aspect. However, pwedeng bunutin, i-withdraw ng NAPOLCOM ang deputation ng mayor on the following grounds. Eh, laging absent si mayor, laging wala sa opisina. Abusado si mayor. And of course, si mayor is a supporter of criminal elements. If the NAPOLCOM finds that the mayor is doing this, the mayor will be barred from supervising or having clout over the PNP. Eh, mali na yung ginagawa niya. Kaya yung deputation, i-withdraw ng NAPOLCOM. Okay. And if the mayor is engaging in acts inimical to the national security of the state and the city, okay. Oh, tapos na pala tayo, mga kasama. That ends my lecture. Okay. Let me proceed, no? As I told you, I garnered number 11 in the board exam of 1995. Anong ginawa ko dyan? Ito, discarded dyan. This is just a brotherly advice, mga kasama. Ngayon pa lang, ang pampaantok nyo sa gabi, hindi ML. Hindi mang kanor, ha? Lagi kayong merong hawak ng mga review materials, hard copy or soft copy, basa. That will be your pampaantok. And then, YouTube ang inaano nyo. YouTube ang tinututukan nyo. O, di ba? So, pampaantok ka, makatulog ka, pagising sa umaga, fresh na fresh, basahin mo. Kayang-kaya mo sagutin yung mga tanong sa binasa mo kagabi. Tuloy-tuloy yan, tuloy-tuloy lang. Huwag niyong paghahalu-haluin. Kung CDI itong linggon to, siguro CDI. Habang nag-iintay kayo ng board, basa lang ng basa. Nung panahon namin, wala kaming makita sa net ng mga questionnaires na lumabas. Nowadays, di ba? Voluminous, that you can find volume of reviewers. And you must always open, and this is not advertisement, you must always open the live coverage or the video coverage of the reviews conducted by AMISI Review Center. Libre! Nakikita niyo po si Idol FJ Piraro doon, tsaka si Sir J. Piraro, tsaka si sino pa, yung mga attorney, yung mga law enforcement officers, yung mga criminologists. Oh, higit sa lahat, ang panday. So, gentlemen and ladies, isa yun sa style. Then, one thing more, when you are given a notification of the room or of the building or the venue of your examination, one day ahead or 2 days before you visit the area kung saan kayo mag-i-exam. Okay? And once you're already there, you should be there 30 minutes or 1 hour in advance. Bago kayo pumunta dyan, a night before, wag na kayong mag-review, wag kayong magpupuyat, mga impacto kayo. Okay? Dapat fresh na fresh kayo. Walang inom, walang puyat, walang mangkanor. Okay. Then, pag nandun na kayo sa venue, feel free to go around the room. Tingnan mo. You relax yourself. Diba? I-feel mo yung ambience para feel at home. Remember, in taking the board exams, hindi ka naman makukulong pag bumagsak ka, diba? Do not rattle. Don't be nervous. Eh, no, kung bumagsak di sa susunod, eh, punta, sayang naman na nareview ko. Remember that. Relax and always pray to the Almighty. Lord, tulungan mo po ako rito. Okay. Nando na kayo ngayon. Ongoing ang exam. Mga kasama, remember this. Sa pagmamadali, maraming nadadapa. If you think you do not know the answer for number 3, skip number 3. Be sure that when you skip number 3, you answer number 4, yung sagot mo ilalagay mo sa number 4. Kasi pag nailagay mo yan sa number 3, tuloy-tuloy ng mga nasagot mo, puro mali na. Shadings lang yan. O, di ba? Kaya kailangan be sure. Kung bakante ito, iwan mo. Mahirap ka, mamaya kita babalikan. Elementary pa lang tayo. This is already being taught. Babalikan kita mamaya. Then, there is enough time for you. Huwag kang magmamadali. One thing more. You finish CDI subject this morning for 2 hours. 4 hours, dalawang subject. Okay. Break time, alas 12. Labasan ngayon. Kwentuhan. Tol, ano sagot mo sa ganun? Ganito eh. Eh, ganyan. Ay, pucho, mali. Sisisihin mo na ngayon ang sarili mo. Magulo na isip mo. Ang isip mo, nandun sa nangyari kanina. Wala na yung isip mo doon sa para sa review mamaya. Kalimutan nyo na yung exam kanina. Tapos na yun. Hindi mo na mababawi yun. Diba? Kaysa na maawayin mo sarili mo, yung tug mo sarili mo ron, yung ulo mo ron. That is taboo. Relax. Tapos na yun. Wala na akong magagawa ron eh. Okay. Then, pagkatapos ng exam, pagdating ng hapon, you relax again, mga kasama. Review konti, basang konti. Huwag mong pupuyatin ang sarili mo if the exams will be held tomorrow. Okay? And always pray to the Lord Almighty. Lord, tulungan mo po ako. Karir po, habang buhay po itong trabaho gusto kong pasukan. Simba-simba lagi. Oh, see? Hindi, you cannot pass the exam. You cannot reach your goal without the assistance of the Almighty. Remember that. Ha? Tsaka pagka nag-exam pala kayo, no? Pag you believe na yung A is mali, nagduda ka, buburahin mong maigi. Kasi pag dumaan sa makina yan, may shadings pang natira yan, yan ang nabasa, mali pala. Mali ka na ron. Kaya pag binura mong maigi, at itiman mo ng maayos, yung talagang choice mo, yung bet mo, that's it, mga kasama. Okay, in the meantime, I will stop by this. I hope I will be given another chance by your, the organizer of this review center, to take another subject for you to be reviewed by me. Kahit ano, kahit na mangkanur, sanay ako dyan, private lesson, private lecture. Just joking, my friends, gentlemen. And please, pasensya na kayo, medyo mahina ako sa computer technology, and at the same time, this is my very first time. Kailangan kong pagbigyan yung idol ko, si Attorney Jay Peraro. Pagdating ng araw, he will be my lawyer. Gratis din. Libre, and the joke lang. So, gentlemen and ladies, I'll see you sa... If ever I'll not be given another subject, I'll see you during the oath-taking sa PICC or wherever, and I'll see you along the streets. Remember, kahit saan nyo kumakita, you may send your request by calling me by my nickname, and my nickname is S-I-R, Sierra India Romeo, Sir. Assalamualaikum, mabuhay po kayo lahat, inshallah.